Hello everyone, this is R.S. Agarwal. Today I am going to discuss how to prepare organization theory. You know, organization theory is part of paper 2 of commerce and accountancy optional in civil services. In paper 2, there are OT, OB, HRM and IRs. So let us move ahead. The syllabus of organization theory, it consists of 7 broad chapters. First is nature of organization and their environment. Here you will come to know what an organization is. Second is organization goals. Here you will come to know what are organization goals and why organizations exist. And third to seventh, there is focus on how organizations work or how can they work in a better manner. So broadly, the chapters of organization theory can be put into 3 parts. First, what is an organization? Second, why organizations exist? And third, evolution of organization theory and other things that talk about how to make organizations highly effective. Right? Let us see. List of books. For preparation of organization theory and organization behavior, one very good book is B.P. Singh, T.N. Chhabra. The title of the book is Organization Theory and Behavior. It will cover all the chapters of organization theory except chapter number 4. Chapter number 4 deals with organization design and challenges. Right? Many things of organization design and challenges are covered in this book, but not all the things. So you need to see a book, Organization Theory by Gareth Jones, only for chapter number 4, not for other chapters. Besides this, to get very good marks in commerce or any optional, you need to update yourself with the corporate world practices, NGOs and government examples. Since organization theory as given in your syllabus is not business specific, so your organizational examples should be examples of government functioning, examples of business organization, examples of NGOs, etc., not any particular kind of organization only. Right? And if you want to get all of these at one place, we are rankers classes. You can go for our study material or you can see our class notes. So both of them cover syllabus very well. Right? Let us see the broad strategy. Broad strategy requires exact and high level of conceptual clarity. On the basis of conceptual clarity, you can write any answer. Around 30 to 40% of the stuff or content can be written by you on the basis of conceptual clarity. But it is not sufficient. You should have memory of important terms like organization structure, hierarchy, span of control, scalar chain principle, ideas, theories, and pointers. That will provide the main stuff or main content for your answers. Always our focus is on answer writing. And another, integrated knowledge of various theories and concepts in OT will help other chapters. For example, your knowledge of organic structure will help write answer on flat structure and decentralization. Your knowledge of mechanistic structure will help you write answer in tall structure, formal structure, right, and bureaucratic structure. Besides this, since organization theory will deal with your day-to-day experiences in organizations, like you might have visited any store, any office, any corporate world. So there you see application of organization theory. You have been visiting at banks. So in banks, you see the structure, you see the culture. You have visited private sector banks, public sector banks. So your experiences, common sense and creativity can contribute to around 20 to 30% of your total answer. So these are the 4 broad areas that need to be prepared by you, that is concept, facts, integrated knowledge and your common sense that should be applied. Besides this, to write very good answers, you should do regular answer writing practice during your study of organization theory. Take care, it should start from very first day you prepared or you read any 5 pages of organization theory. There is no perfect preparation other than answer writing, right? Do that. Plus, you should do 4 or 5 revisions of your syllabus so that you are having better conceptual clarity, better memory, better integrated knowledge, and you can apply your common sense in a proper manner. So 4 or 5 revisions must be done till final examination, starting with the first reading till one day before the exam. So that is the broad strategy. Now let us see the detailed strategy. Right. Detailed strategy I will provide as per chapter. on nature of organization and their environment, you must have hold over thinkers. You should prepare thinkers on two areas. First is definition related thinkers, like Chester Bernard, E.W. Bakke, etc. And on environment, you should prepare. On organizational environment, there are various thinkers like Mintzberg, like Thomas, right? They should be prepared. If you see PYQ's questions have been asked on definition given by prominent thinkers and environmental thinkers. Besides this, you must have knowledge about features of organizations and importance of organizations and limitations of organizations. So these are the three broad areas you should prepare in unit number one: definition thinker, environment thinkers, and nature, feature, importance of organizations. So three broad type of questions are asked on unit number one. Come to unit number two, that is organization goals. With regard to organization goals, you should prepare various kinds of goals. You should also prepare how goals are set. And prepare rationality in goal setting. Must prepare individual goals versus organizational goals. IG means individual goals. OG means organization goals. So must prepare what is conflict in between and how to resolve the conflict. Also prepare fourth aspect, management by objectives. So these are the four broad areas that need to be prepared on organization goals. They are core of a goal chapter. Thereafter, unit number three, evolution of organization theory. In evolution of organization theory, there are four main thoughts. First is classical thought. Second is neoclassical theory, modern theory, and most modern theories. With regard to these theories, you should prepare three important things. One is the concept covered in the theory, and main proposition. Proposition means core idea. For example, what is scientific management? So one best way of doing the work, techniques and principles of scientific management, that is core proposition. You must prepare merits of each thinker and limitations. Limitations or criticisms are very important. Questions have been asked on criticisms. For example, cynical puppeteering. It is a criticism of neoclassical theory. Another is red tapism. It is a criticism of classical theory, that is bureaucracy theory. So similarly, question may be asked on hoarding of authority. It is a criticism of Weberian bureaucracy. Right? So these must be prepared. And another thing is that need to be prepared is superiority of one theory over another. Definitely these theories are developed in a sequence during 19th century, at the end of 19th century, start of the 20th century, this was propounded. To overcome limitations of classical thought, neoclassical thought emerged. So how neoclassical theory is superior than the classical theory? And in order to overcome limitations of both, modern thought was developed, that is system theory and contingency theory. So you must know how system theory is superior than classical and neoclassical. And you must also know the important features of most modern theories like virtual organization like learning organizations. So here also paper setter has been asking questions on superiority of one theory over another. So these are the three broad areas on theories. Come to fourth. On organization design challenges, design of organization means organization structure and organization culture. Though there are many design challenges, but three challenges are very important. First is centralization and decentralization. The name of the challenge is balance. Though in syllabus it is written that balancing centralization and decentralization, but practically you must prepare everything about centralization. What is centralization? Diagram of centralization, merits of centralization, demerits of centralization, whether 100% centralization is feasible or not. And same thing about decentralization. And thereafter, how to balance both. Another area which is very important is formal and informal organization. Here the title is coordinate. So syllabus includes coordinating formal and informal organization, but you must prepare everything about formal organization. What is formal organization? What are the features of formal organization? Merits, limitations, and similarly for informal organization, how they are beneficial for one another, and thereafter must prepare coordinating both. That is important. And last is line and staff function. Line and staff function, that is also an important structural challenge. Here 10 marker to long answer questions are asked. Must prepare what is line structure, why staff is needed, conflict between line and staff, utility of line and staff, benefits of line and staff, right? Variety of things are asked on this. So these three important challenges or three important areas must be prepared very well. There are other challenges also on which questions are not generally asked. For example, differentiation and integration. Question is not asked. Another is standardization and mutual adjustment. Once only question was asked. Another is mechanistic structure and organic structure. So in these areas question may be asked, but not very important. Prepare these well, right? Let us see next. Kinds of organization structure. In your syllabus, three kinds of organization structure are covered. First is functional. Second is project. And third is matrix. Among most important is matrix. If you see past year questions, a lot of time questions have been asked on matrix structure. Must prepare it very well. So tick marks are given for preparing it very well, right? So prepare it very well. Thereafter, function structure is important. And here questions are asked rarely, but it is not a not more than 2-page material. So you should prepare matrix structure very well. What is matrix structure? How it works? What are the merits? What are the limitations? How it differs from project structure, right? Similarly, you must prepare what is function structure, how it works, what are the merits, what are the limitations, and how to overcome the limitations of functional structure. So these are important areas. Next is the power structure and politics. So prepare this as a short note also. You may be asked to write a short note on power structure and politics. Prepare it. Second, you may be asked a question on significance of power. Power and significance of politics in organizations. Organizations must prepare tactics to gain power. एंड फोर्थ हाउ टू हैंडल पॉलिटिक्स। इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस सो इन दिस चैप्टर दीज आर द इंपॉर्टेंट एरियाज दैट शुड बी प्रिपेयर्ड। दिस इज अ स्मॉल टॉपिक एंड वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली क्वेश्चन आर नॉट आस्ट बट स्टिल यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर इट। नाउ मैनेजिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक लाइक अथॉरिटी लाइक लाइन एंड स्टाफ। विद रिगार्ड टू मैनेजिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर यू मस्ट नो फर्स्ट कंसेप्ट ऑफ कल्चर हाउ इट अमर्जेज। सेकेंड यू मस्ट प्रिपेयर मैनेजिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर मीन्स हाउ टू मैनेज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर। द टॉपिक इट सेल्फ इज मैनेजिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर। मैनेजिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर इट मे बी आस्ट इन मैनेजिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर यू मे हैव टू राइट क्रिएटिंग कल्चर चेंजिंग कल्चर। अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट एरिया फ्रॉम वेयर क्वेश्चन आर रिपीटेड इज सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर। ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर एंड लास्ट विच इज एमर्जिंग एरिया इज हाउ वुड यू क्रिएट। हाउ वुड यू क्रिएट ए पार्टिकुलर काइंड ऑफ कल्चर। सो यू शुड प्रिपेयर फॉर एग्जाम्पल हाउ डू यू क्रिएट जेंडर सेंसिटिविटी कल्चर। हाउ डू यू क्रिएट सेफ्टी कल्चर। हाउ डू क्रिएट पॉजिटिव कल्चर। सो दिस वे क्वेश्चन में बी आर सो दिस आर द इंपॉर्टेंट एरियाज यू नीड टू प्रिपेयर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कल्चर। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट डिटेल्ड प्रिपरेशन राइट। आई वुड लाइक टू टेल अबाउट अस वी आर रैंकर्स क्लासेज स्पेशलाइजिंग इन कॉमर्स एंड अकाउंटेंसी। आई एम टीचिंग कॉमर्स फॉर द पास्ट 21 ईयर्स। वी हैव प्रोड्यूस्ड मोर देन 270 रैंक्स। वी आर हैविंग टॉप मोस्ट रैंक्स लाइक रैंक नंबर 2 दिस ईयर ग्रीमा लोहिया एंड बिफोर दैट रैंक नंबर 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 15, 20। सो इन टॉप 30 देर हैव बीन डजन ऑफ रैंक्स विद कॉमर्स एंड अकाउंटेंसी एंड फ्रॉम रैंकर्स क्लासेस राइट। इफ यू वॉन्ट टू विजिट अस यू कैन विजिट अस एट फॉलोइंग एड्रेस दैट इज इन ओल्ड राजेंद्रनगर मार्केट। यू कैन विजिट अस ऑन अवर वेबसाइट दैट इज रैंकर्स क्लासेज डॉट इन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ड्रॉप ए मेल। सो दिस इज अवर मेल आई डी एंड यू कैन मेक ए कॉल टू अस राइट। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन थ्योरी एंड रैंकर्स क्लासेज। थैंक यू।